The RoboMaster S1 needs to be used with the RoboMaster app. You can use the app to control the S1, engage the S1 in single and multiplayer games, and write programs. The RoboMaster app is available for iOS, Android, and Windows. In this video, we will show you how to use the RoboMaster app. Download the RoboMaster app in the App Store or on Google Play. Or you can scan the QR code in the user guide. Download and install the app. Open the RoboMaster app. Tap the user icon at the top left to set up the player account. Tap the Connect button on the top right of the screen to connect the app to the S1, following the instructions provided. The three menu bars on the bottom are Solo, Battle, and Lab. Tap Solo to enter the FPV screen. You can make the S1 move forward, backward, to the left, and to the right via the virtual joystick on the left side of the screen. Press and hold any free space on the right side of the FPV page to control the gimbal. Aim at a target and tap the launch icon to shoot infrared beams. The default firing mode uses infrared beams, but users can change the firing mode to gel beads in the Settings control menu. The center of the screen will show the FPV gimbal angle readout and sight. This can help you control the gimbal and improve your aiming. The top right of the screen shows the S1's battery level and Wi-Fi signal strength. Tap the Settings icon to go to the Settings page. The real-time armor hit point information is shown at the bottom of the screen. Tap the video or camera icon to record a video or take a photo. After enabling the S1's voice transmission function, you can listen to real-time audio from the S1's microphone through the app. The three icons at the bottom right of the screen are Custom Skills icon, Follow Mode icon, and Target icon. Tap the Follow Mode icon, and the S1 will be able to lock onto and follow a person. Tap the Custom Skills icon to release a custom skill. To improve aiming, tap the Target icon, and then the image shown on the screen will be magnified 4 times. Tap the Trophy icon at the top left of the screen to enter Solo Mode. Solo mode includes target practice and target race. Users can hone their skills with shooting practice using this mode. Tap the exit icon to return to the main page. In the battle page, you can battle against other S1s when all S1s are connected to the same router. You can choose from race and free-for-all modes. Tap the exit icon to return to the main page. In the lab page, you can check out Road to Mastery to learn how to program and to explore robotic and AI knowledge. These courses gradually increase in difficulty, allowing users to eventually solve problems with their own unique solutions. In DIY programming, users can program using visual programming language. In Robo Academy, users can check the video tutorials and learn robotic and AI knowledge. Go back to the main page, then click the Settings icon. You can check the S1's status in the Robot menu, and you can connect the app to the S1 in the Connect menu. In the Display menu, you can change the S1's LED color or information shown on the FPV page. 3D quality is used for adjusting the image quality of the S1 model on the main page. In the Control menu, you can change the speed, firing mode, control sensitivity, and other settings. In the System menu, you can change the app's and S1's language. You can also address the S1's armor, motor, and calibrate the gimbal and chassis here. Tap the Announcements icon at the top right of the Settings page to check the release notes. In the Media Library, you can view the videos and photos you have taken and share them on social media. If you have any questions when using the S1, go to Guide for technical support, or contact online support to give your feedback. DJI support will handle any issue promptly. Thank you for watching. hit the like button if this tutorial was helpful. If you need any support with your DJI gear, feel free to contact us via Facebook Messenger by following the link in the description. Thank you for watching.